Hello friends, this is a beautiful topic of English language of content. This is all about content analysis. Every teacher analyzed the content before going to the classroom. He thought about the objectives, design the activities and thought about evaluation process, and this is a beautiful unit that will help our teachers, teacher educators as well as pupil teachers in their teaching learning process. So this is a commitment before going to the class. Content analysis of the text is a prerequisite for better teaching learning process. So, objective of this unit, after completion of this unit, you all identify the language items, design learning activities for transaction, make a content analysis of the text, use the content analysis for developing a lesson plan. So now we will discuss how to analyze the content in a systematic process. So for that, first of all, we have to divide the whole text into some sense group paragraph. Then we will design learning activities for transaction, then develop a lesson plan for transaction of each SCP. So today I will show a content analysis on the topic Akbar and Birbal. Then first we will divide the whole text into some SCP. Then we will put those things into this format. First we will write the name of the text. Then we will prepare plan for the particular SCP and main ideas in that SCP, vocabulary and expression of that SCP, structure and pattern of the SCP and functional grammar of the SCP. So we divided the topic into three SGP. First SGP contains three paragraphs, SGP 2 contains four paragraphs and SGP 3 contains the rest para of the topic. So in the first SGP, the main ideas are Akbar's characters, his love for scholars, famous nine gems. Then the vocabularies and expressions are wise, scholar, gem, sense of humor. Structure and pattern. Here complex sentences are there, clause pattern are there, and then the functional grammar. Next, in SGP 2, the main ideas are Akbar's love for hunting, lost way in jungle, met a young man, and the vocabulary and expression are stare, to hold, one's breath, call out, get back, and laugh at. And the structure and patterns are direct and indirect speech and dialogue. And the grammar part is direct to indirect and indirect to direct, as well as var plus preposition. In the third SGP, the main ideas are Birbal's reply, how he replied fearlessly, Akbar was angry, And the vocabulary and expression are dare, temper, fearless, late one, then the structure and patterns, direct and indirect, and preparation of questions. Then functional grammar, contracted forms. After that, we will prepare the learning objectives. So, friends, you have to divide the whole text into SGP, and you know how many periods are required to complete the text. For each period, we have to develop a lesson plan. Each lesson plan is guided by a set of structural learning objectives, developed on the basis of identified contents in each sense group paragraph. Now, take up the task of formulating the learning objectives. So, the learning objectives are of two types. First one is general objectives and the second one is specific objective. In general objective, the learner will develop the fourfold language skill, enrich their stock of vocabulary, make various uses of language. And in specific objective, it is particular for a topic. Here the specific objectives are from Akbar and Birbal. So the learner will read and comprehend the text, describe the character of Akbar, explain why Akbar loved the wise men and their company, use words such as wise, scholar, gem, honor, advice in proper context, derive different forms of words in the text like humorous, wise, wiser, wisest, respectable, scholarly, etc. Then read the text aloud with proper punctuation, stress, pause and intonation. Now, you all have understood how to formulate the instructional objective of an SGP. So, let's take up the activities of working. So, let's take up the activity of working out learning instructional objective of the second and third SGP of the topic. So, now we will prepare some activities. There are three stages during teaching. First is pre-reading, next is while reading, and third one is post-reading. So in pre-reading, we plan some activities for the learner to introduce the topic for motivating the learner, and also reading aloud by the teacher if required. And here the skill or focus are specifically listening, speaking, and this is important that we should interact among the learners. And in the second stage, while reading, we focused on silent reading, because silent reading gradually leads towards understanding. And after that, the learner asked questions posed for meaningful reading. And here the skills to be focused are reading for comprehension, intensive reading, guessing the meaning of the words, expression, and interacting in the group. And in the last stage, post-reading, the teacher will ask different types of questions for helping comprehension. Here, the student will formulate sentence and uses the grammar and they applied the questions for evaluation of learning objectives. And the skills to be focused: scanning and skimming, listening, speaking, reading, writing competency, reading practices, application in new situation. So scanning and skimming, these are two sub-skill of reading. Now you have to innovate more activities in addition to what is given in the textbook. A good content analysis shall help in formulating appropriate learning instructional objectives, working out activities for transaction of the lesson, and finally for developing a lesson plan. Thank you. Have a good lesson plan and deliver a better lesson. Thank you very much.